In this presentation, I'm going to introduce constraint satisfaction problems. These are used in artificial intelligence when you need to make a bunch of decisions in parallel, and you can model those decisions using variables. So in a constraint satisfaction problem, we have a number of variables, x1, x2, x3, up to xn here, and every variable has a number of choices that you can make for the value of that variable, and we call that the domain. So here we see x1 can have the value 1, 2, 3, or 4, that's called its domain. We also have a set of constraints, and the constraints are the things that don't allow you to assign some of the values to the variables. So for example, a simple constraint could simply be x1 cannot have the value 3. That's called a unary constraint because it only involves a single variable. We can deal with those very easily by simply removing that value from the domain of the variable. But we also have binary constraints. Those involve two variables. So for example, here we have x3 must be greater than x4. And what we have to do with the problem is that we have to find a consistent set of values for all of our variables so that none of these constraints are broken. So what we're looking for is a solution. A solution assigns a value to each variable such that none of the constraints are broken. The simplest algorithm that we can use to solve the problem, not the best algorithm, but the simplest, is known as backtracking. And I'm going to illustrate that process on this problem here. So we have three variables, A, B, and C. The domains of these variables are the values 1, 2, and 3. In general, you're allowed to have different domains for different variables. It just happens here that I've got the same domain for each of my variables. Here are my constraints. A must be greater than B. B is not allowed to be equal to C, and A is not allowed to be equal to C. So I can solve this problem by a simple process whereby I go through all of the possible values, one at a time, and then if I reach an assignment of values that breaks the constraints, I backtrack. I backtrack to the last decision that I made and I try another value. Let's see how this works. So I'll start with A. I've got to assign a value to A, and the first value that I can assign is 1. So I'm going to try that first. This is known as a partial assignment. So it says A is 1, but I don't know the values for B and C yet. I now need to look at this partial assignment and see if it fits with my constraints. A is greater than B. Well, I don't know what B is yet, so that's okay. B is not equal to C. I don't know B or C. That's okay. A is not equal to C. Well, C doesn't have a value. So all of these constraints are okay at the moment, but then I don't know much about the problem so far. I've only got one value for one variable. So now I move on to B, and the backtracking algorithm is systematic. It goes through all of the values in turn, left to right. So we start with B is equal to 1. We've now got a partial assignment with two values in it, and we check them against the constraints. So let's look now. A is greater than B. Ah, that's broken. A is not greater than B here. So therefore, that's not a possible assignment of those values, and therefore I have to backtrack. So I backtrack on the last decision that I made, and I try another value for B. And I just take them systematically left to right. Now you notice that the algorithm isn't being particularly intelligent at this point because it's trying greater values. It's systematic, as I said. So A equals 1, B equals 2. Well, that breaks that constraint as well. A equals 1, B equals 3 is the next one after the backtrack. That's no good as well. So at this point, we've tried all of the possible values for B, We can't backtrack onto another value, so we need to go back to A and backtrack on that. So we now try a different value for A. We've tried that one, and we found that we can't have a value for B, so now we're going to try that one. So A equals 2. That's okay. A greater than B, B not equal to C, A not equal to C, that's fine. So we now move on to B and try the values one at a time. Notice that we go back to B equals 1 because we've got a new value for A. So A equals 2, B equals 1. Well, A is greater than B, that's okay. B is not equal to C, well, we don't know what C is, so that's okay. A is not equal to C, again, we don't know what C is, so that's okay. So we're happy with this and we can now move on to C. And we try the first value for C. C is equal to 1. A is 2, B equals 1, C equals 1. Well, A equals 2, B equals 1. Well, that one's okay. B is not equal to C. Ah, it is. So this one is no good. And we have to backtrack. So we backtrack on the last thing that we did, C equals 1. And we backtrack to a second value. A equals 2, B equals 1. C is equal to 2. That's okay for this. A is indeed greater than B. B is not equal to C. That's okay. A is not equal to C. Ah. So that one's no good because that constraint is broken. We now backtrack again here. A is equal to 2. B is equal to 1. C is equal to 3. Check the constraints. That's okay. That's okay. And now that's okay because A and C have different values. So that is the complete solution found by backtracking.